Hi everyone, I'm Claire, and I'm back for Brilliant Botany Episode 2 with some summer reading recommendations from some of my favorite botany-related books. Now, for my first recommendation, I couldn't pick one of Amy Stewart's books, so I have three of them. Amy Stewart is a science writer who typically writes about plants. She also has a book, Wicked Bugs, that I don't own because I'm more of a plant person. But the first of these is Wicked Plants by Amy Stewart, which is a really great... It's almost like a reference. You could definitely read it through, but it's basically a history of plant poisons and their different uses, ranging from food to weapons to famous people who have died, all sorts of things. And it's actually a really gorgeous book. It's a really nice hardback. I'm a book geek, so I really like it for that. And it has really great illustrations. The second of these is the first one I read by her, which is Flower Confidential. And this is the good, the bad, and the beautiful of the cut flower industry around the world. It talks about breeding blue roses, breeding the stargazer lily, which I mentioned in my last video, how roses are cultivated and shipped from Ecuador, Guatemala, all around the world. And it's super interesting, super well written. It's more of a narrative than a science book, which is something that I really love about it. The third of these is The Drunken Botanist by Amy Stewart, her newest book. And similar to Wicked Plants, it's a really gorgeous hardback with some great illustrations. And it is little anecdotes in each chapter or section is a different plant and how alcohol is derived from it. So it's basically any alcohol you can think of is in here with backstories. Fruitless Fall by Rowan Jacobson, The Collapse of the Honeybee, and The Coming Agricultural Crisis. It was published in 2008, so it's a little bit outdated in terms of talking about colony collapse disorder, the disease condition that was striking all of the world's, or at least the United States, bees in the past couple years. But it is a very great book if you want to learn about how bees work and communication and hives. It's very great. As you can see, I have lots of post-it notes in it because plants and bees are both very, very important. This is one of my absolute favorite books, The Wild Trees by Richard Preston. It's about coastal redwood research in Northern California and how that started within the last couple of decades and the men and women who started that area of research. One of the first researchers, Steve Sillett, free-climbed into a redwood canopy without any gear just to stand on the crown of a redwood, and it's believed that he was one of or the first man to stand in the crown of a redwood tree. This is more of a practical recommendation. This is Newcomb's Wildflower Guide. It's mostly based in northeastern America. I'm sure it reaches up a little bit into Canada. It's what I've used in my plant systematics courses to identify plants, and it's a really great, easy-to-use guide, so even if you aren't a botanist and don't know that much about plants, you can use it to identify stuff in your area. You basically need to be able to tell how many petals a plant has, how its leaves are arranged, which will be explained to you in the book, and what shape those leaves are, also explained to you in the book in terms of options. And then it leads you through questions, and you can basically figure out using pictures and descriptions what plant it is you're looking at. And there you have it, some summer reading recommendations if, like me, you have some downtime right now. And if there is a particular topic you're looking for a book on, drop a note in the comments and I'll see if I can come up with a recommendation for you. Similarly, if you have any botany-related questions, leave those in the comments and I'll answer them in a future video. Summer reading recommendations.